Hey guys, welcome back to my channel. My name is Noelle and today we are talking about the Nike Infinity React Flyknit 2. So I have been teasing this shoe review for the past 2 weeks or so. I do have a review up on the Nike React Infinity Run Flyknit 1. So if you want to check it out and then compare it to how I'm going to review version 2, then you can check it out. You can click up right there or in the description box below. And I will also be referring to a lot of the things comparing between the two versions of this shoe. If somebody owns version 1, is it worth it to upgrade to version 2? Especially since the difference of time is only 1 year. So we're going to get started with some general info for those of you who have not encountered the React Infinity line from Nike. Basically, Nike launched a campaign to reduce running injuries. So they wanted runners to be able to run more often without fear of, you know, getting injured. With regular running shoes, you have either 2 or 3 distinct lines. You have your neutral line, and then you have support or stability, and then there's another line. Some brands don't have it, but some brands do, and it's called the motion control. Basically premising itself on the amount of pronation a runner's foot goes through as they go through their running stride. You know, run science and technology has progressed since they started making these distinctions in running technique, and currently I think the jury's still out on whether or not you do need to control the amount of pronation a runner's foot undergoes. I am not as knowledgeable about it as others are. So basically what Nike has done with the React Infinity line is that they've basically made a neutral shoe which has some stability features, which completely blurs the line between the neutral and the stability distinctions. So basically they took all of the feedback that people gave them on version 1, they put that into improving onto version 2. So the things that are still the same between version 1 and version 2 of the React Infinity is the widened midsole, and it cradles your foot a lot more. I think I mentioned in the first review that instead of your foot sitting above, just on top of the midsole, it actually sits inside the midsole a little bit. A rocker-like bottom, which guides your foot through that stride to reduce side-to-side wobbling. So it makes your foot go straight instead of your foot landing and then going sideways this way or that way. So that's the claim. So immediately upon visual examination, you already see the major difference. This version 1 is a very sock-like upper, very thin layer as well. There is no tongue, so these laces are practically decorative instead of being functional. They do lock the foot in a little bit, but not as much as with a traditional tongue and lace setup. Version 2 is more, has more construction behind it. So it's still Flyknit, but it's multi-layer. You see here that collar is pretty thick and cushioned. And there you go. That is the tongue. Very traditional construction. This part of the shoe, around the midfoot, around the top of the arch, is also well supported with a lot of flywire. I think you can see that right there. That's flywire right there, which wasn't present in version 1. So as you can see, version 2 is very, very, very beefed up. And I'm sorry about the strange shadows right here because the sun is shining directly into my bedroom. I've drawn a shade across the window, but it's causing some really strange shadows across my face. Hopefully that doesn't really distract you a lot from what I am about to say, okay? So that is the main difference between the React Infinity 1 and 2. It's really the upper. And I've read some reviews that say that the change in the upper is enough to take the Infinity from a good shoe to a great shoe. And that's because version 1, a lot of people, including myself, said that because of the lack of construction in the upper, it really felt sometimes like my foot would fly off the sole. Although that's never happened, and my foot is actually quite secure inside the version 1 shoe, version 1 upper. But it's just the sensation, the general sensation that this part of the shoe moves around, and then you can feel your toes kind of moving around. Especially if you're not wearing very thick socks, you can really feel yourself trying to find a space for your toes and the ball of your foot to sit in comfortably in this shoe. The upper is the main difference, but right now this shoe in particular, it's come with glued insoles, unlike the version 1, which we have removable insoles. These insoles in version 2 are still removable, but there's some glue in there. So I'm not sure why they glued it on. And I'm afraid if I pull the insoles out right now, I might not be able to keep them in the shoe. In any case, I'm not the kind of person who needs to change insoles for additional support and whatnot. But there may be people who do like changing the insoles for comfort's sake. And so that's going to be a little bit of an issue. You can definitely, if you go into a store and try these out, you can remove the insoles and see if your custom insoles will work for them. The reason I've spent so much time talking about the upper is that there is actually no difference in the ride. Like, there's no difference in the feel from landing to push off between version 1 and version 2. It really is none for me. So I ran in the version 1 and the version 2s on separate days, and then on the same day I ran in version 1 first and then version 2. I tried to run approximately the same paces for both trial sessions so that I could really see how it felt. And it really didn't feel much different except for the experience of the upper, in which case my foot definitely felt more bound to the shoe in version 2 than in version 1. The design of this midsole really does keep your foot on track, and that's what it's designed to do. I guess the only thing that version 1 has on version 2 is how stylish the upper really looked. I mean, comparing this flashy shoe, it's a bit hypebeast, right? With this. Which is quite subdued. Although I do love the lavender and then the pop of color, the green. But yeah, this one looks a bit more futuristic than this one. So definitely version 1 has style points over version 2. This might be the winter colorway. And it might also have been released in this dark colorway to kind of address criticisms about the release in this colorway. This was, although it didn't get as dirty as I thought it would, being a white shoe, it's not a shoe that you would want to run in on a muddy or dusty day. And this one definitely, you can take it out in any sort of weather conditions and it will perform like it should, and it won't look too beat up. Should you upgrade from version 1 to version 2? I don't know, it depends. If you found issues with the very, very thin upper on the version 1, then yeah, you should try out version 2. But if you felt really comfortable in the sock-like upper, and that really thin collar, this cushioned collar and lacing system might feel quite harsh. Yeah, I noticed this on the day that I did the split run with both the 1 and 2. Coming from Infinity 1, where there wasn't really a lot of material here, and then coming into the 2, where you have so much collar and then you have these plastic pieces on the top lace hole, it definitely felt like there was something there or something poking into my foot that wasn't there when I was using these shoes. Now, the issue with the version 1 is that this particular tongue section, which isn't really a tongue, was very high. So if you wore no-show socks, this would actually rub up against your foot. It could cause a blister. I think that happened to me when I used these for the Aquathlon, but thankfully the run distance was so short, I didn't really blister. But yeah, I saw that as an issue. If you were wearing no-shows in the version 2s, your only issue would be up here near the top lace hole. So that's something you need to look out for when you're moving from version 1 to version 2. Now, I asked some people on Instagram and Facebook to send me some questions that they would like to ask about the Infinity. So here they are. I'm going to read them out and try to answer them as well as I can. So first question is, which is better, Epic React or Infinity? Which is actually a very difficult question for me to answer because I've never run in the Epic React. And I did read some information that the Infinity React is supposed to be the successor to the Epic Reacts. I'm not sure if that's true, but if that's the case and you really love, absolutely love your Epic Reacts, then I would say hoard your Epic Reacts because I'm not sure if Nike is going to be manufacturing more of those. They might be replacing it with Infinity. Next question, how is the outsole durability? Well, I've not been running in the Infinity React 2s for very long. You can see that they're kind of dirty right now. The outsole was not really that textured except for, yeah, these grip lines were there, but the actual material itself on the grip lines is quite smooth, so you can't really tell how much wear has happened. I mean, look, version 1 had dark outsoles and version 2 has light outsoles. But I do think in general that Nike outsoles, especially the blown rubber outsoles, are very, very hardy. Even if it's not dark and you can actually see these getting really dirty, I don't think that you're going to wear these out before the upper wears out. Is the original still worth buying? And so this person also mentioned that the original, the version 1 is supposed to be, should go on sale. And I have checked the websites. They're not on sale yet. So basically, they're selling at roughly the same price, the 1s and 2s. Like I said, the original has its charms. It's very stylish looking. It has a very, very light upper, and if you're the kind of person who loves your foot not feeling bound too much, then yeah, version 1 is still great. Either way, I would recommend you go to the store and try them on yourself before deciding which one to go with. How does it feel on the heels? I have been running in these at kind of like the slow and steady paces. That's the meat and butter, bread and butter pace of running, where you're not really actively pushing, you're just building your aerobic engine. And so you do tend to land a little bit flatter or towards the back of the foot if you're going slower. Landing on the heels in these is okay. It's not harsh. It's very supported and comfortable, very cushioned as well. But what I like about, I guess what I like about React Foam is that when you land in them, you don't feel like your foot or your energy suddenly goes dead. You do feel a little bit of energy return, pushing up from underneath your sole, So there's a bit of pop in these shoes. Is the shoe suited for short or long runs or both? Well, I have been running in these for short distances. I think the longest I've run in them was about 6 kilometers and change. But definitely, I think these are comfortable enough to go longer. I especially like that I have a lot of room inside the shoe, so my feet swell as the distances get longer, and there's enough room in this shoe for that natural swelling to occur without feeling pinched. It's suited for steady-paced runs. I think it's good for long runs, but you can definitely use them for short jogs where you're just, you know, trying to work up a sweat, or you're trying to use running as a mood booster rather than as an actual workout. These are still great for that. It's great for those casual pickup runs. I wouldn't say they're great for speed work, because I do find that you kind of sit further back on your feet in these for some reason. Although, yeah, you can see that you can rock forward on the ball of your foot. So it's good for promoting turnover. But when you're standing in the shoes and when you're jogging in them, yeah, you do kind of, it's kind of a little bit further back feel versus the Tempo Next Percent, for instance, where I do feel like I was constantly trying to move my weight forward onto the ball of my feet, because it felt more natural that way. This one, it's a little bit further back, so it's suited for steady distances, not really for speed work. Now, would you recommend this shoe for racing? React Infinity. Well, I used the React Infinity 1 in my last race, my last real life race, which was the Singapore Aquathlon. This was last year. I felt okay in them, but I wouldn't pick them up as my first choice for a racing shoe, because really it was just meant to be a comfortable shoe to run often and long in. If you do like making that distinction between training shoes and racing shoes, the React Infinity is definitely a training shoe. For racing shoes, yeah, I would veer towards Tempo Next Percent for a racing shoe. If your budget doesn't wanna go there, then I would probably say the Pegasus would be more of a racing shoe than the React Infinities. Which one has better support and cushioning? I think that because of all the flywire improvements in version 2 of the React Infinity, then it has better support. When it comes to cushioning underfoot, they both felt kind of the same, but because of this upper, which is, you know, it's, I think it's a few layers deeper, and the cushioned collar, it certainly feels more plush, more cushy in a sense, even though it's basically the same cushioning. So yeah, I would say version 2 has better support and cushioning just because of this upper. Would you recommend this to newbies and casual runners? Nike's whole thrust for the React Infinity line is to get people to start running, to love running, and to run longer without risk of injury. So if you want to set yourself up for success right from the get-go, then yeah, definitely should go for the best shoe that you can afford. So if you can afford the React Infinity, then go ahead and get it if it's going to be your first running shoe and you're really going to be dedicated to running. If you're looking for something casual, like you can walk around in, I know Nike has a few other shoe lines that would be suited for that. This is if you want to get started running and you're serious about picking up running as a form of exercise and recreation. And that's that on the Nike React Infinity 2. Thank you so much for watching. If you enjoyed this video, if you found it entertaining, informative, or basically you found your time well spent watching this, then please do give me a thumbs up. And also please subscribe so that you can catch my next videos. Thanks so much and see you next time. Bye!